Right, so that's it, complete. I know what you're thinking, it's not complete. Well, yeah, kind of. Somehow I have to prise these bits together, the bottom plate, middle plate, and the clean top plate. I've got a Mobius camera as well to go on there. Somehow on there, I think for the first outing, I'm running out of time, so I'm just gonna strap it on there with some Velcro or maybe some double-sided tape. Not sure yet, but eventually, and if it does vibrate, if the images aren't very good, then I will knock up some kind of clean plate on there. I've got some vibrating dampener kind of silicon bits I can easy put on there. I think you can buy a top plate now, or clean plate, I think they call it, to actually go with a Mobius, but it's easy enough to knock one up on a 3D printer, so we'll see how that goes. So that'll be going up there somehow. Getting my battery on there, that's a top plate done. Got the FPV camera and the actual template that it goes on. I might knock my own one of these up eventually, again, a 3D printed one. I'm going to need some standoffs or something to make this work for the first time, but again, I just want to get it together, get it in the air, and then work back and do any maintenance on it after that. The wires, a lot of my wires are over length, so they can probably come apart and I can shorten those. I just kept them full length so I could reroute them and play around with the way I'm going to wire it up. Also gave me an option if the motors were rotating the wrong way, then I could kind of jiggle things around a little bit. But amazingly, every single motor rotated the correct way, which was a 50-50 gamble, and it worked. ESCs, tuck them in, zip tie a few things, a distribution board. See if I can get it in short. Distribution board, that worked out well, but really on this one, I could have sort of, I don't know, I could have probably got away with just a standard distribution board. The camera actually is a 12 volt camera. The picture quality as well, I've had a quick check of this, and it does all work, the FPV kit now, and the picture quality is pretty good, I have to say. Can't remember how much it was. I got three of these and they were cheap. I had to look again at the price because they were that cheap. But this, I'll see how it goes in the actual contrast in the outside light and dark. So, but first impressions are they are pretty good. They're getting better and better and the prices are coming down of these. So hopefully it'll last. If not, I'll look to get another one. So I'm hoping that'll be good enough. If not, then I will look for something a little bit more expensive, but yeah, should be okay. That's a bit overkill as well. It's like a 600 milliwatt transmitter, video transmitter, but I had this laying around. It's off one of my other copters and it's spare at the moment, so I'm going to use that. And where's the other? There's my Futaba. I've got Velcro on. I might just Velcro on that to start because I'm not sure I'm going to keep that to Futaba on. I might just put a basic Spectrum on there, and then the handset I can just kind of carry around because this one I'm going to shove in a backpack and take to places where you can't really access with your larger ones. You can just throw it in a backpack with the control, and I don't want my best remote control handset thrown in a backpack, so that's the plan of that. I'll fly it while I can on this Futaba, see how it goes, and then maybe swap over to the Orange because I've got an old, I think it's a DX7, I don't know, something like that, which I'll throw on this eventually, possibly. What else? I need to fit well, just literally fit all of this in together, squeeze it all in there. I'm going to use a bit of dampening on there. I might just hardwire it. I'll see. See how it all goes. I need to remove the. So look, I've got a couple of wires here which should have been used to power the actual FPV camera. That's like a 5 volt outlet from the Immersion RC stuff. But I'll just pop those off. I don't need them because I'm pulling all the power from that printed circuit board. So I did the software calibration on this. It was a bit of a wizard that you just followed and defaulted yes, no, flicked a few buttons here and there, calibrated the motors, start points, calibrated your transmitter, and no real gains. I know I looked later on at the software and you can kind of keep tweaking it to the heart's content, but everything is default. There's nothing to say that this is set for a smaller quad, larger quad. The settings, I assume, would have been the same for a 260 size and a full-blown monster size. So whether the gains and settings will be good enough for this, no idea. We'll find out shortly when I throw it in the air. It's blowing a gale at the moment, and it's getting late in the day, so I'm not going to get it in the air. I told you I could squeeze all of that equipment onto such a small frame, kind of. I didn't actually think it was possible, but once it's all together, it's quite neatly packed, I have to say. I need to do quite a lot of work still on the wiring, routing. I need to tidy a lot of things up, which I've just... I mean, I'm getting it together so I can put it in the air. There's lots of things, lots of small niggling things. It won't affect its first flight, I know that, but lots of small niggling things. I always use these XT90s, and if you were using the JSTs or something a bit smaller, it would be an advantage in these things. But I always use them, all my batteries have got these on, so I'm kind of stuck with these XT60 plugs, and I think it's about a 14 gauge wire, which is sort of overkill for this. I'd use a smaller gauge wire, because I kind of find it hard to squeeze in between the gap and top of the board, so I could have gone smaller, and it doesn't bend as much. If I'd gone a smaller gauge, I could have bent it through the frame a little bit more. This is a little bit rigid, so I've had to rework it a couple of times trying to get it so it lines up with my battery, but once it's hooked up to the battery, it should pull it away clear of the props. So yeah, when they take that apart again, I will definitely look at rewiring that thing, just niggling things like that. I've got lots of things velcroed on. I need to sort my aerials out, get a better line for the receiver aerials. At the moment I've got them on the back, on the back side of it, one forward, one backwards facing. That needs sorting out because I'm not happy with that. It's just taped on. The receiver, which is on the top plate, upside down on the top plate, and sort that out. So I've got the receiver upside down again, that's velcroed on, which I don't like, but again it's temporary whilst I work out what goes where. I'll definitely be able to make a more permanent mount for that. The Mobius again is just velcroed on for this first test, which I've just pulled the velcro clean off. That's not good. And just for this first test, I am going to do some kind of 3D printed board on there, just to make it more secure. I don't like that at all. So that's a Mobius, the FPV camera. I had it focused, I had it all set, and then I went and knocked the focus ring. So I'm going to have to reset that next time I power it up, which will be tomorrow. Hopefully it's blowing a gale again. All in all, the wiring of the motors as well. You can see I've got a bit of excess wire coming out there on all of them. I mean, that can easily be sorted out just to hide it all, make it neater. The wiring or the placement of the ESCs was a little bit tight at the front, and that's those green things there, and at the back. I got them to work in the end. But and the zip tied on, which I'm not sure about either. Like I say, everything is pretty much temporary until the next time I take this thing apart, and then I will be having a proper look at it and put everything as I want it. Center of gravity feels pretty good. I've had to move the battery further forward than I thought I'd have to. And that's a 1800 one, so I've got a lighter one than that, which you'd have to go even further forward. But again, the batteries, you can see the zip ties too far back for my liking. It does have velcro on it as well as a safety measure just for the first few flights. It won't move anywhere, but yeah, it's definitely not a nice location, because I would have moved, because my receiver's under there. There is like a little tag I could hook to, which would be perfect right in the middle, but I've got my receiver directly under there, so it gets in the way of the velcro. So there's the video transmitter neatly tucked away. I think this is a three leaf clover antenna, which I'm not that happy about. I've not really had, it's not been bad, but it's not been brilliant either. Somewhere in between. I've had a lot better reception with the four leaf on the video transmitter, and I have not got any spare ones. I can pinch one off one of my TBS ones if need be, but we'll see how this goes. For distance wise, it should be good for what I need, I hope. It's a little bit exposed there at the back. It could do with tucking in a little bit more. I didn't realise I had so much room there, but it is sticking out a little bit, which is good for reception, but bad for crash damage. I'm just thinking that's the first thing that's going to hit. Yeah, it wouldn't have to go that much further forward for it to be in a better location. Again, that's just small niggling things that once you get them together, you realise, oh yeah, I could have done it better that way. Some of the screws, they're always too small, these screws. Material's dead soft. That post there is cross-threaded. I tried to use a different screw in there because I already broke one. And I've cross-threaded this actual standoff, but I do have a spare from one of my other Flip FPV machines. Same height, I think. Just eyeing it looks the same height. So again, when I take it apart, I will sort that out as well. I mean, the video transmitter could have maybe sat on the top deck there. That would have been even better. With the battery location there, you see, that may well be, yeah, I could put it on there, maybe extend it a bit, that'd be okay. Right, so there we go. Next video of this is with it in the air or in a tree, you just never know.